Well, of course, cybersecurity as an industry is already one of the largest segments of IT, about a $40 billion market growing at 7% a year. But when you have an incident like this WannaCry incident you mentioned, it only serves to remind all of us, it's sort of a worldwide kind of wake-up call that we have to really redouble our efforts to get the basics right in security and how important it is to do that.
I want to ask you about the NHS, because we saw a fairly significant disruption over the weekend on the back of this cyber attack. You provide products, security products for NHS.
And we do.
There's been some consternation about a tweet from your website that was changed saying the NHS is totally protected with Sophos to Sophos understands the need of the NHS over the weekend. Was the tweet changed? Was that correct?
Well, it was actually a marketing site that we put up about 2 years ago that we took down about, it hasn't been used for about 18 months. I think the key thing with the NHS is to first understand, as everyone in Britain knows, the NHS is not one single entity. It's hundreds of individual trusts that all have their own IT budgets, their own decision making, and their own approaches to protecting themselves.
So you're saying it's a leaky sieve?
I'm sorry?
You're saying it's a leaky sieve?
No, I'm saying it's a group, it's a federated group that makes each of their own decisions. And we work with a number of NHS organizations, not all of them, but the ones that we were working with that had the full complement of products that we offer, particularly a new product that we came out with that was precisely designed for exactly ransomware and to fight it, they were fully protected. So the products worked just as they were intended to.
But the other entities that didn't spend the money on the product that you were talking about, they were not protected and they were not fine.
Well, it depends, because there's a variety in any IT organization. And of course, there's hundreds of thousands of organizations that have been affected by this, right? It's not just the NHS. But what you see in any of those organizations is that there's layers of defenses you can put in place. And we have a whole suite of products, and there's multiple layers that effectively prevented against this attack. And some of the organizations had one or more of those layers in place, and some didn't, and that determined how they kind of, what the effect they saw of this particular attack.
Can we go back a state? This wasn't the question I was going to ask you, but email. Email is the way in, it seems, always into these things. You tap on a file and it looks great, and you think it's from HMRC.
Right.
Is there something we can do about email? Because it's quite an old-fashioned medium now for communicating compared with all other. Is there something that you guys are doing around email that just says, actually, we need to move away from email, or can you never fully protect yourself if people can open a file that says, look at my lovely photo, bang, done, you're in?
Well, email is sort of becoming the equivalent of talking in real life. I mean, it's just becoming a massive go-to communications channel. So one
still,
of the, oh, of course.
Because I'm just wondering if it's archaic for our children and for what.
Well, they. I mean, yes, there's Snapchat and so forth, but email continues to be a massive, massive communications vehicle. I don't think the answer is to stop email. The answer is to make people more aware of how they're managing their email. One of the offerings we have is to help organizations understand and simulate phishing attacks so that they can just get their antenna up so they can be smarter and not just blindly click on everything that pops up. I will say one other thing, which is there's still data emerging, but as our researchers continue to pour into this particular WannaCry ransom attack, it actually looks like the initial infection, if you will, did actually not take place through email. It looked like it may have taken place through a physical device that somehow got inserted into the network,
Wow.
which is actually quite interesting to
that
think about how that might have occurred.